immune system is this fantastically evolved ecosystem within our bodies that takes up an enormous amount of energy and effort. And it evolved over millennia for us as humans to be able to eliminate all these threats to life and limb, things like infection, trauma, and ultimately cancer. But to be honest, it evolved primarily as a system to get rid of infection. So early in our development, infection was probably the main threat. And it comes in two, broadly speaking, there are two arms of the immune system. There's the innate and the adaptive. Innate means inborn, meaning it's the sentinels of the immune system, and they come in different types, and there are different types of cells. And there are many different cells that make up the immune system. So there are many different players, or think of them as soldiers. And you have neutrophils, you have macrophages, you have monocytes, you have eosinophils, all of which are sort of primed, ready to go. They're kind of like the soldiers standing guard at the gate. And as soon as there's a threat, they'll react, and they'll react quickly. And they won't have memory, because once they do their job, they're used and that's it. Then there's an entire separate arm of the immune system. Think of them as the reserves. Soldiers waiting in the barracks, waiting to discern whether there's a threat to life and limb. And that's the adaptive immune system, which is very different. It has specificity. It can recognize very specifically a threat versus a non-threat, which would be non-self versus self. And it has the ability to have longevity. Those cells, we call them B cells and T cells, can last for decades in your bloodstream once they recognize, say, a virus. And they have this amazing memory that is, once they recognize a threat, they can still live on in the bloodstream in your body. And years later, when that threat again resurfaces, they can react very quickly and very strongly. So you have these two different systems within a system, and they do a pretty good job of fighting infection, other inflammatory influences. And I wish that they did a better job of fighting cancer, but we're now beginning to understand how to exploit them to fight cancer.